Hello students, in the previous class we have observed the Heisenberg uncertainty principle and also de Broglie theory. Now let us discuss about Schrödinger wave equation, one more model of the atom, that is quantum mechanical model. So generally quantum mechanics, this is a branch of chemistry which deals with the dual behavior of matter, that one we call it as quantum mechanics. Okay, so here it explains only about dual behavior only, means it explains both wave-like and also particle-like properties. So when quantum mechanics is applied to macroscopic objects, means when it is applied to large particles, so automatically what happens means it is related to classical mechanics also. This one mainly developed by here 1926 by Werner Heisenberg. And also here to describe the wave and particle nature mainly, we can say here to describe wave character and particle character of the electron. Erwin Schrödinger derived an equation to describe wave character and particle character of the electron. Erwin Schrödinger derived an equation for the electron in the hydrogen atom, we can say. In hydrogen only one atom we are having, for that only he has described, that one only it is given by the equation. This equation we call it as wave equation, Schrödinger wave equation we can say. So it is written by the, so the Schrödinger wave equation is nothing but dou square psi by dou x square plus dou square psi by dou y square, dou square psi by dou z square plus 8 pi square m h square e minus v into psi is equals to 0. Listen clearly, this is the Schrödinger wave equation we can say. Means what? It describes both wave character and also particle character of the electron. Okay. So means what? Only we are describing about only hydrogen atom of the electron. So here we are finding the probability of an electron also. But that's why we are taking three axes here. That is x square, y square, z square. So that's why the equation will be here, dou square y by dou x square, dou square y psi by dou y square, dou square psi by dou z square, and 8 pi square m by h square into e minus v into psi. Okay, this is nothing but psi as we know. So which is written as, so this can be written as also h cap psi is equals to e psi. So here h cap means what? Here we can say h cap is nothing but here minus h square by 8 pi square m dou square by dou x square plus dou square by dou y square plus dou square by dou z square plus v. Okay, so this is nothing but h cap. So this h cap is nothing but here Hamiltonian, which is a total energy operator we can say. This is a mathematical operator and this operator we call it as Hamiltonian. So what here, where h cap we call it as Hamiltonian operator, which is a total energy operator, we can say. If you have observed here, see h cap is equal to minus h square by a by, so the psi will be common, that is dou square by dou x square we are getting. So h cap psi is equals to e psi hat hold. So if this will go this side, then automatically what you will be getting, this automatically it will go means minus h square minus 8 pi square m e minus v psi. Okay, so that only we have written here. So h square will come here, it will go multiplication and it will come divided, then dou square by this common will be getting, so plus v again you are getting. So this is nothing but the Hamiltonian operator. So here the term psi we are having, so here whenever we are taking psi, okay, so means what, here the term psi in the equation, whatever psi we have taken in the equation, that one we call it as is known as, sorry for the disturbance, the term psi in the equation is known as amplitude function, or we can say wave function. Okay, amplitude function or wave function, with psi square we call it as probability function. If suppose psi square we are having, that one we call it as what is known as probability function, we can say. So in this there will be psi square and also psi we are having. So one physical possible solution of the wave function are acceptable here, that is we are having such wave functions physically possible or meaningful solutions of the wave equation are acceptable, that such wave functions we call it as eigen functions or eigen values. Energy values and a wave equation we call it as eigen functions, wave functions that is, and energy values we call it as eigen values here we are having. So means what, here wave equation is known as what, here eigen function. And energy values we call it as, corresponding energy values we call it as here eigen values. Okay, so these two we are having here, one is eigen function, another one is eigen value here. So generally this quantized energy states which is having wave functions, there will be three quantum numbers, that is principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number, magnetic quantum number. Okay, so these all will be given by the solution of Schrödinger equation. So if you take electron in any energy state and also the wave function corresponding to energy state, it give information about the electron. So the wave function is a mathematical function whose values, it depends upon the coordinates of the electron in an atom, and it will does not carry any physical meaning. Okay, so such type of wave functions of hydrogen with one electron we call it as atomic orbitals. Such wave functions which is giving one electron species, that is one electron system which we have finding and probability of an electron at a point with an atom is proportional to psi square at that point. Okay, so the it what it give then quantum mechanics of hydrogen atom, he successfully explains about the hydrogen atom spectrum including some phenomena that could not be explained by the Bohr's model also. So there will be application also for this. That will be here. The further wave function psi will be acceptable, we can say. One physically, sorry, for a wave function we can say here, generally psi to be acceptable, the following conditions. For psi, the conditions is, means for eigenfunctions, the conditions we are having is, psi must be continuous. Psi must be continuous and also it should be finite. And this psi should have single value only. Okay. And also probability of finding the electron. Probability of finding the electron over all the space. From plus infinity to minus infinity must be equal to 1. Okay, so means what here? It should be continuous, finite, and it should. Means if psi, means the wave function psi, if we are accepting, it should satisfy certain conditions. In that first condition, it should be continuous, it should be finite, it should have single value. So whenever you are finding an electron over all this space, so it should have plus infinity to minus infinity. Means for example, like this we are having plus infinity to minus infinity, which is equals to 1, we have to say. Okay, so then the value of psi square at a distance r from the nucleus, so this is a nucleus, so this is a distance r, okay, from the nucleus. So then the value of sin square, here we have spoken about the only sine. So whenever you are finding the value of r square, then at distance r from the nucleus, it indicates probability of finding the electrons at that point from the nucleus. So what it indicates here, this indicates what here, the value of psi square at a distance r from the nucleus indicates the probability of finding the electron at that point from the nucleus. So then what will be the radial probability function here? The radial probability function will be function d is equals to 4 pi square d r dot psi square, we can say here. Then the value of radial probability function here, the value of radial probability function at any distance r from the nucleus what it indicates? It indicates that See here, the value of radial probability at any distance r, it indicates probability of finding the electron in a spherical dish shell of thickness dr at a distance r from the nucleus, we can say. Okay, so then we have to plot a curve. There will be a curve for this. Means what here? The probability of finding an electron. Probability of finding the electron in spherical shell of thickness dr at a distance r from the nucleus. So means what here, if you have observed here, generally if you clear the same from the equation, we have seen the psi value and how to find the, means the psi square is giving the plus infinity to minus infinity to find an electron about that is equals to 1. So if you have taken that, the value of psi square at a distance r from the nucleus, what it indicates? So means what, we are getting a psi square value at a distance r from the nucleus. So it indicates that we can find electron at that point from the nucleus as we have seen. So then we are getting this radial probability function is nothing but, means for example, if you have taken radius of this pium 4 pi square r. Okay, so in the same way here we are representing here, it indicates that the diameter or radial probability of function is nothing but 4 pi square dr into psi square. So then what happens, the value of radial probability function at any distance, if you take at any distance r from the nucleus, it indicates that we can find an electron in a spherical shell, means at any distance, not only here, if you have taken this distance, if you have taken this distance, at any distance what happens, probability of finding an electron, from this only we are finding an electron, okay, in spherical shell. So this is a spherical shell of thickness dr at a distance dr from the nucleus, we can easily find. Okay, so this is nothing but here, means what we can say, an atomic orbital wave function psi, it represents the state of an electron in an atom. So it can be described in particle nature and also wave nature. So this radial probability distribution curve, it is plotted against between the d function and also distance from the nucleus. So this is about Schrödinger wave equation. So we are having next orbits and quantum numbers. Let us discuss about orbits. And quantum numbers. Okay. So generally atomic orbitals are quantized energy states, we can say, which are differentiated, characterized by quantum numbers. So here the quantum numbers is a natural consequence in the solution of Schrödinger wave equation. So according to Bohr's model, what we can say, the principal quantum number indicates the size of the orbit. So according to mechanical model, what we can say, the principal quantum number determines the energy of the electron in the case of hydrogen atom. For example, if you have taken, here we have discussed only one atom, that is hydrogen atom. If you have taken multi electron atoms, then the energy of electron determined by the principal quantum number, that is we call it as, and also azimuthal quantum numbers we have described. Okay, so here we have to take large number of orbitals which is possible in an atom, which is qualitatively it differentiate by size, shape, orientation also, which means smaller size means it more chance of finding the electron near the nucleus. Similarly, shape and orientation means that more probability of finding an electron around the directions, we can say. Okay, so we are having four quantum numbers, that is principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number, and also magnetic quantum number and spin quantum number. Now let us discuss about each by one. One by one, let us discuss. Okay. What is our first one? Principal quantum number. So generally, principal quantum number means what here? Who has discovered principal quantum number? According to Bohr, we can discuss about the principal quantum numbers. Atomic orbitals are differentiated by what we call it as quantum numbers. So then what is orbitals? An atomic orbital is nothing but what here? Which describes the an atomic orbital describes about what? The probability of finding an electron, okay, from the nucleus, that when we call it as orbital, we can say. So means what? A different point, the probability of finding an electron, we call it as what here? Atomic orbital. So let us discuss about that is an orbital. Let us discuss, it consists of the quantum numbers. Consists of four types. What is the first one? Principal quantum number. Second one, azimuthal quantum number. Third one, magnetic quantum number. And fourth one, we are having spin quantum numbers. So these are the four types we are going to discuss here. Now let us discuss about today principal quantum number. First of all, let us discuss about principal quantum number. So here, sorry for the disturbance. So principal quantum number here, principal quantum number means it was discovered by, first of all, it is proposed by Niels Bohr, we can say. And denoted by letter N. So this principal quantum number was discovered by Niels Bohr and it is denoted by letter N here. And here generally it has the values like 1, 2, 3, 4, where N is equals positive integers we are having. Okay, so means what here? We can say in the sphere K, L, M, N orbits. So if you have taken, this is a K, this is a L, this is M, this is N. K, L, M, N. So like this, the values we are going to have, that only 1, 2, 3, 4. So here maximum number of electrons in a given main energy level is
2n square we can say. Okay, so the maximum number of electrons in a given main energy level is 2n square. Okay, so this principal quantum number explains about the size and energy of the orbital. For example, if you take an hydrogen atom, okay, for hydrogen atom and hydrogen like species, helium, lithium, energy and size of the orbital depends upon the value of n only. This also determines about the identify about the shell. Means if the value of energy increases, automatically the orbital also increases here. So whenever the shell KLMN orbitals is increasing, the size of the orbital increasing, automatically principal quantum number of value n increases. So here by this what we can say, electrons will be away from the nucleus. Means what, the electrons whatever we are taking, it is far distance from the nucleus. So here energy is required to shifting the negatively charged electron from the positively charged nucleus. That's why we are taking here energy. So energy of orbital will increase with increase of n. So whenever the orbital is increasing, automatically the principal quantum number will also increase here. Okay, so what is its significance, what we can say mainly for principal quantum number? It describes about size and energy of orbit. Means as size increases, automatically the principal orbit will increase and also the principal quantum number n also increases. And next one we are going to have is azimuthal quantum number. So azimuthal quantum number, it is proposed by mainly. So it is proposed by Sommerfeld. We can say it is proposed by Sommerfeld. Okay, so and indicated by what here? Indicated by letter L, we can say here. So L has the values 0, 1, 2, 2 and minus 1 we can represent. So this L has values what here? L has values 0, 1, 2 up to N minus L, N minus 1 we are having. So here it represents sub levels. Okay, means what here? Present in the main levels. So in this we are having some of the levels, that is only sub levels we can say. These are the main levels K, L, M and other. So these are the sub energy levels, means S, P, D, F blocks we can say mainly, that only sub cell rotation. So whenever we are writing here L has values of 0, means what? It represents sub levels. Present in the main level. So what is the significance? We can say describes only shape of the sublevels, means whether it is spherical. If we have taken SPTF blocks, it describes only shape of the levels, that is only spherical, dumbbell, double dumbbell, fourfold dumbbell, like that it can describe. So remaining it cannot describe. If for example if you have taken in the first shell n is equals to 1, then L will be 0. If you have taken subshell L is equals to 0 comma 1 in the second shell, that will be n is equals to 2. Okay, if 3 if you are taken, the third shell will be n is equals to 3 and so on like that. Each subshell is having an azimuthal quantum number L. So they will be having different values. So what is the significance we are having? So the significance about this one we are having is it describes shape of the sublevels. So what is here? Sublevels is S, P, D, F blocks. Here shape is nothing but spherical. Dumbbell. Double dumbbell. Fourfold dumbbell we are having. So what will be the L values we are having here for the 0, 1, 2, 3 we are having. Okay. So this is about sublevels. This is the shape and L values. So now let us see next one, magnetic quantum numbers. So it is discovered by proposed by Linde and indicated by letter small m. So it is having the values. M has values from minus L to plus L. We are having including 0, we are having these values. Okay, so what happens? It represents orbits which is present in the subshell, we can say. So what are the orbits we are having? It mainly describes that only. Orbits in the subshell, sublevel we can say. So it explains, what is the significance? It explains only orientation of the values. Okay, what is the significance? Its significance is it describes orientation of orbitals. In space we can say, so here if you take sublevel,